Very good afternoon, dear students. So today on 27th November 2020, as per timetable, in our online classes, MA semester third students who has opted the specialized paper of population studies, I am dealing with the second paper, and within that second paper, the third last unit is taking place. Yesterday I told you about the push and pull factors of migration through which Evers Lee's theory of migration emerged. That was the first theory of migration, and today I will deal with Ravenstein's law of migration or Ravenstein migration theory. This is also a very important theory. Propounded by Ravenstein, but you have to check it and you have to practice it and you have to experience it in the present scenario, especially in the COVID era, and link the theory with the development of any country. Okay, so let us move towards the theory. So dear students, first we should know who invented this theory and from where he belongs. So this theory is formulated by Ernst Georg Ravenstein, originally from Frankfurt, Germany, and he made his observation based on migration to the United Kingdom, and that work was published in 1885. So just remind yourself, then this was the period of Industrial Revolution in the Britain, and that time Ravenstein, through his experience, through his observation, propounded theory of migration. How? Using the birthplace data, Ravenstein identified a set of generalizations which he called as law of migration. Okay, and that concerning inter-country migration in Britain in the 19th century. Most of this generalization hold good even today. That is why I was telling you. So learn this theory, learn this law, but use in the context of modern economic scenario. So let us start with the basic concept of this theory. Most migrants move only a short distance. This is the primarily and basic point of Ravenstein, and that you should learn that most migrants move only a short distance. So you have to check according to your country, circumstances, place, and there is a process of absorption whereby people immediately surrounding a rapidly growing town move into it, and gaps they leave are filled by migrants from more distant areas, and so on until the attractive force, that is called as pull factors, is spent. So dear students, this is the basic concept behind the Ravenstein theory. And then you can see the Ravenstein law of migration, and let us learn about the certain important points of Ravenstein law of migration. So to begin with, let us start that every migration flow generates a return or counter migration, number one. Number two, the majority of migrants move a short distance. Earlier I told you. Next, migrants who move longer distance tend to choose big city destinations. Okay, next, Urban residents are often less migratory than inhabitants of rural areas. These all are the observation derived by Ramsden, and you have to learn before dealing with this theory. Families are less likely to make international moves than young adults, and along with other influence includes migration that is stage by stage. I will tell you later on. Migrants links with technology, and last is economic condition. But again, there are certain few factors, certain few components, according to Ravenstein, which affects the migration. That is, females are more mobile than male in the country of birth, but male more frequently ventured beyond. So all I am urging all the female students to do research regarding these issues. And migration is highly age selective, where adults in the working age groups display a greater propensity to migrate. This is also an area of research. And volume of migration increases with the process of diversification of the economy. This is very much important nowadays, that volume of migration increase with the process of diversification of the economy and improvement in the transportation facilities. So you can see in India nowadays, every city is moving towards diversification of the economy. Even our Varanasi city is also moving towards the diversification of the economy. Okay, and there are lots of work doing for the improvement in the transport facilities. And जैसे जैसे ये सब विकास होगा वैसे वैसे मूवमेंट मोबिलिटी माइग्रेशन होगा भारत में भी, और भारत का भी शहरीकरण तेजी से बढ़ेगा और भारत विकसित होगा रविस्टन की थ्योरी के अनुसार. ओके, सो माइग्रेशन अकर्स मेनली ड्यू टू इकोनॉमिक रीजंस. इसलिए इकोनॉमिक रीजंस ही आपको समझाने हैं. सो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ दिस इज द बेसिक थ्योरी रिगार्डिंग दिस ग्राफ. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दैट most migrants move only relative short distance. Earlier I told you in the concept, and there is an inverse relationship between the number of migrants and distance travels, and this is also called as distance decay theory. So you can see y-axis is number of migrants, x-axis is distance. Less distance, highest migration; more distance, lowest migration. So you can see that most migrants travel short distances and their numbers decreases as distance increases. And I can show you a more specific diagram where you can deal with this theory. That you can see, this is a interaction intensity and this is a distance graph. Okay, so you can see this is a slight low, moderate, high, and very. So very high distance is small, interaction is very strong, and distance large, interaction is slight. So this graph will move downward slope. Okay, and this shows that distance decay in the term of migration, that is, in the small distance more migration takes place, in the large distance slight interaction or migration takes place. So this theory, Ravenstein's theory, is also called as distance decay theory. Through this diagram you can explain it. Okay, and I have also explained with very rough way doing exercise at my home. You can see this is a places, this is a kilometer, this is a migrants number. A place distance is very low, 15 maximum number are there. B kilometer is high, kilometer is more, migrants are low. C more distance, less migrants. And D more distance, again less migrants. E more distance, again less migrants. And this is up to G more distance, minimum migration. So this can be also, you can draw with this hypothetical statistics like this distance decay theory. Anyone you can use in the examination. And again, the second one is also important, which Ravenstein used to say. This I have also explained for you in the rough diagram. And again, I will show you in the specific diagram. You can see this is x axis is a rural background. Suppose there is a rural background, complete country is a rural background, and with the development process, this is a y axis is a migrant structure. Okay, so firstly there are rural areas, this in development took place, this is a small cities, then with this rural areas people moves from this, from the here, from this to here, from this to here. So this is the first step, lower distance, and from then people used to move from this place to the bigger city. So this is first step, this is second step, and maybe the third step is the international migration. So Ravenstein also tell that migration took place stepwise step, and this you can see in this diagram. There's first very step, first step maximum migration, second step little bit less migration, and this step by steps took place like this. So second portion of Ravenstein says that migration takes place stepwise. This is also called as stepwise migration, जिसको कहते हैं हिंदी में सोपानी चलन, प्रवसन का सोपानी चलन, यानी प्रति प्रवसन स्टेप वाइज या सोपान की तरह चलते हैं, पहला कदम दूसरा कदम, इस तरह छोटे नगरों से वे लोग बड़े नगरों में जाते हैं, और बड़े नगरों से तब हो सकता है कि अंतर्राष्ट्रीय माइग्रेंट होके बाहर चले जाते हैं. सो फर्स्ट इज ए डिस्टेंस डिके थ्योरी, सेकेंड इज ए स्टेप वाइज थ्योरी. And when you have to explain the long distance commuting, then you can say who moves to long distance, and that is various factors: household composition, social ties, housing market, transportation, labor market, preference and norms, and last but not least is individual characteristics. These all factors affect who, all the migrants, to move towards long distance commuting. So as per Ravenstein theory law, we can see there is a prospects of migration. You can see in 1950 29.1% was global city, and around 2020 that moves to 54.9% of city, and that prospects in 2030 is 59, and 2040 64.7. so as per stepwise step, distance wise migration takes place, the urbanization will take place, and this is the link between migration and urbanization, or migration with development. So dear students, this was the second